Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Adri Adventurous Catholic. So last week I made a video regarding the Latin Mass, my first experience, my first impression of it. And this was a few years ago, around 2017 was the time I went to the Latin Mass. I experienced it for the first time. And after posting this video, I got a few questions from people asking me for advice on how to engage more with the Latin Mass and how to experience it better if it is your first time or you're very new to attending the Latin Mass. So I realized that in my other video, I really only talked about the positive things I noticed about the Latin Mass. There were definitely a few challenges that I'll bring up in today's video, and I'll also share with you the missal that I have and some tips that I would recommend to engage more with the Latin Mass. Let us get started. Let us get started in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. In nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Alright, so starting with the challenges that I face attending Latin Mass for the first time, the first one is that I couldn't understand it. Why? Because I don't know Latin. I mean, I grew up, I was raised with Spanish, which is closer to Latin than English is, but it's still a very different language. And being in the Mass for the first time, I mean, I knew that the Mass was going to be celebrated in Latin, but it was still difficult for me to sit through 2 hours and not really be able to follow along with what was happening, mostly because there were missals that the church had and they were lending to people, and I was trying to find the pages and it just didn't make sense to me at first because there was nobody to really walk me through it and I didn't know how to go about it. So the first thing that I would tell you if you've never attended a Latin Mass before but want to is that you don't have to understand it. You don't have to be following along. I actually recommend going without a missal for the first time and just watching everything that happens and experiencing the Mass for what it is without trying to know every single thing that's being said and everything that the priest is doing or fully understanding it, because eventually you'll get there. But I think that I would definitely recommend, if it is your first time, just go and just live the experience without trying to understand everything right away, because that is something that did frustrate me just a little bit in the beginning, until like halfway through the Mass I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna put this missal down and I'm just gonna watch what's going on. And it was such a fuller experience and it was so profound because of that, because I decided, you know what, I'm just gonna set this down, I'm just going to see what's right in front of me. And so I would recommend that to you as well. The other thing that could have frustrated me if I let it, but I didn't, was that I'm used to, because I grew up going to the Novus Ordo Mass, I'm used to just knowing the lyrics to the songs that are being sung during Mass. And because the songs were chanted in Latin, I couldn't follow along with it. I didn't know how the song went, and like I said, I could have let it frustrate me if I wanted to, but I decided instead to just let that be something that brings me closer to God, and it was beautiful. I realized through that I didn't need to sing along to deepen my relationship with Christ through the Mass. I was still able to have a unique and beautiful experience, not knowing what exactly was said in the lyrics. Because eventually you'll get there, eventually you'll go to the Latin Mass enough that you start to hear the same songs and you begin to understand what's actually going on. So that was definitely another thing that was a little bit of a challenge. The other thing that I know some people definitely struggle with, even going to Latin Mass many times, is that you have to kneel for a very long time. And so being inside a church is obviously different than outside, Currently, the Latin Mass parish that I'm attending is outdoors in a tent, so there's no pews. There's nothing to really like lean on when you're kneeling. You're just kneeling and that's it. So it is a bit more painful. Whereas inside the church, when I went for the first time, it was indoors. There are pews, so you know you can rest your arms there, and that can kind of help you better balance the pain, and you don't feel it all on your lower back or all on your knees. So that's a minor difference, but it can still be difficult to kneel for a very long time if you're not used to it. I wasn't used to it, so the first times I went, it was a challenge, it was painful, and if I let that frustrate me, I could have easily said, you know what, I don't want to go to this mass because it's painful. But if we have that mindset, we are missing the point. The point is to be there and to be present and to unite our sufferings to the sufferings of Christ. You don't think God suffered when he was on the cross? You don't think that he felt, this is painful, I don't want to do this anymore? Yes, he did. And no, this doesn't mean that you should go and take upon all the pain that Jesus did on the cross, but when there are little chances for mortifications like this, such as kneeling during Mass and or standing for a long time, then we can offer up those mortifications and they are very fruitful. So don't let that discourage you. If you feel like you don't want to go because you don't want to kneel for a long time, that's the wrong mentality to be in. Take courage, get up, try it, and there are so many more benefits that come out of it. I think that's why I overlooked those little challenges when I made my video last time, because I realized that they weren't such a big deal. They weren't the end-all be-all. Despite that, I continued going, and it is incredible. I don't regret it. So there are the few challenges that I definitely encountered, and many people encounter as well. So you are not the only one if you are feeling this way. All right, so next I wanted to share with you the missal that I use, because you may be wondering which one you should get, or maybe you're just watching videos to see which one people recommend, because that's what I did before I bought mine. I actually watched Dr. Taylor Marshall's video where he compared a few different versions, and he ultimately recommended the Father Lassance missal, and that's the one that I ended up getting, not only because of that video, but there were a few people that actually recommended this one and said that it was easy to follow along to, and I agree. It's really easy to follow along with. It's not the cheapest. It is pretty pricey, but I do think it's worth it. It is definitely worth it if you're going to be attending Latin Mass and you want to follow along with the readings or different things that the priest is doing or what he is saying. And so this definitely walks you through the Mass. I know that there are also some little missals, we could say, that only go through the translations of the prayers and stuff that is said in every Mass. So the difference is that these, the very big bulky ones, have everything for the whole year. I mean, it just repeats itself every year. They don't have different liturgical years. Like in the Novus Ordo Mass, there's year A, year B, and year C. But with the traditional Latin Mass, it's always the same. It just repeats itself every year. So once you buy a missal, this is all you need to like go to Mass, like always. So that's cool. Also, this leads me to the third point, which is how to engage more with the Latin Mass. The missal helped me to really engage with the Latin Mass because in the back, I love, this is like my favorite part of my missal, is that they have general devotions. So I'm gonna show you that. There are a lot of prayers here that you can do even outside of the Mass, but my ultimate favorite part, the part I use for like every Mass, is where, is it this one? Yes, here. So they have prayers that you can do before communion. That's right here, before communion. I don't know if we can see, it's kind of blurry, but there are prayers you can do before communion. I like to do this during the offertory because It is the act in which we begin to unite ourselves to God. And then after communion, so then they have prayers after communion. I love these prayers. I don't know if every missal has them, to be honest, or if they do, if they're the same ones, but they have prayers that you can do during the mass. And I take advantage of this section because I love these general devotional prayers. They have litanies, they have regular Catholic prayers that we may already know, but they have a lot that I personally didn't know before. So I love going through it and praying some of these prayers during the mass. So that's how I personally would recommend engaging more with the mass. But even if you don't have a missal, you can still do that during the consecration, during the long periods where you just feel like it's very silent. That silence should only be a means for us to grow deeper in our prayer and offer up the mass for whatever intentions we have and talk to God. Use that time to just really sit there and contemplate his presence, contemplate his goodness, contemplate all the blessings that he blesses us with every single day. And that's it. I don't want to lecture you too much, but I did want to just say a little bit of that because we can all get better at engaging with the mass, even in a Novus Ordo parish. This is not only for Latin mass. Other than that, I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something new. If there are any follow-up questions that you may have, feel free to comment down below because maybe other people can benefit off of the answers. Don't forget to hit the like button if you liked this video. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. God bless you all. Stay faithful, my friends, and I will see you all next week.